Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très heureux d'être ici en compagnie des ministres Anand, Joly et Vandal, du chef-major de la Défense, Wayne Eyre. Secretary General Stoltenberg, Jens, what a pleasure to welcome you back to Canada. The last time you were here with me was in 2019, where we visited CFP Petawawa. I'm very pleased to welcome you to Alberta this time and was really happy to be able to take you yesterday on your first ever visit to the Canadian Arctic. It's a pleasure for me to be back in Cold Lake. I've campaigned through here, but this is my first time visiting the base, so I'm really pleased to be able to thank the members of the Canadian Armed Forces who serve here. It's my first time to the Cold Lake base, but it's not my first time visiting Four Wing. In 1982, I visited with my father Four Wing, which was based in Baden-Schollingen, near Baden-Baden in Germany. And that was one of my first tastes of just how Canada's commitment to NATO is deep and serious and continues today. Another family connection I was moved by, I got to see a plaque commemorating 417 Squadron, which is based here in Cold Lake, but that operated during World War II in North Africa and Sicily. And my grandfather, Jimmy Sinclair, was a flight lieutenant in that squadron and was part of the war effort back then. So there's a lot of family connections, as so many Canadians have, to the Canadian Armed Forces and to our history. And it's a reminder how important it is that we continue to support the women and men who serve every day to keep Canada safe. Over the last few days, we've had a chance to talk about the security challenges the world is facing. The Canadian Armed Forces have been able to show us their tremendous expertise. We've discussed the security threats posed by climate change and its unique challenges in the Arctic. And most importantly, we've had a chance to see Canada's strength on the Western and Northern approaches to NATO. Cette semaine, ça fait six mois que Vladimir Poutine a lancé son invasion brutale et injustifiable. Le Canada, avec nos alliés et partenaires, continue de soutenir l'Ukraine. On ne peut pas laisser des régimes autoritaires avoir recours à la violence pour redessiner les frontières des pays souverains. Putin thought he could get away with his unjustifiable war, but he underestimated the Ukrainians and he underestimated the solidarity of our Western democracies. NATO allies are more united than ever, and allied militaries are standing strong in our defense and deterrence postures. As you know, Canada leads the Enhanced Forward Presence Battle Group on NATO's eastern flank in Latvia. Approximately 1,000 brave members of the Canadian Armed Forces are deployed in Europe as part of Operation Reassurance, where they work shoulder to shoulder with soldiers from across allied nations. Canada has also recently announced major investments to modernize our NORAD capabilities, which will contribute to strengthening NATO's northern and western flank. These investments represent the most significant upgrade in Canadian NORAD capabilities in almost four decades. We're providing state-of-the-art equipment our armed forces need in order to defend our security and our sovereignty. And we will be developing our northern capabilities in consultation and partnership with the Indigenous communities that have called the Arctic home for millennia. To the members of the Canadian Armed Forces I've met this week, and all others just like them, who put their lives on the line every single day, thank you for your service and dedication to Canada and Canadian values. All Canadians are grateful for your bravery and your expertise. Aux membres des Forces armées canadiennes, je veux vous dire merci pour votre service et votre dévouement. Les Canadiens sont tous reconnaissants pour votre courage et votre savoir-faire. And I know from conversations with Jens and other NATO allies, it is always incredibly appreciated when Canadians continue to show up and step up and in so many cases lead as part of NATO operations, not just in Europe but around the world. Here at Cold Lake, Jens and I will be able to see firsthand the Canadian Armed Forces Combat Ready Forces, the world-class tactical fighter force training, and all the contributions you've provided to NATO missions. This base, Four Wing, is proudly home to some of Canada's best fighter pilots. It's also a hub for NORAD operations, as well as a launching point for Canada's Arctic and Northern operations. Canada has a unique expertise in Arctic environments. Yesterday, Secretary General Stoltenberg and I visited Cambridge Bay in Nunavut. We toured a North Warning System site and the Canadian High Arctic Research Station. We spent a lot of time with Inuit community leaders. We heard about the ways global warming is changing the Arctic environment and changing the very terrain on which our Canadian Armed Forces operate. It is clear to researchers, military experts, and both the Secretary General and I that climate change is a risk multiplier. Not only are wildfires and floods increasing aid demands on the CAF, but globally, climate change is raising the risk of conflict. We need to take action to address its impacts on national and international security. Au printemps dernier, l'OTAN a accepté l'offre du Canada de mettre sur pied un centre d'excellence pour les changements climatiques et la sécurité ici au Canada. Ce centre va contribuer, entre autres, à orienter la recherche, la formation et l'éducation. Canada has also offered to be the North American home to NATO's new Defense Innovation Accelerator for the North Atlantic. The initiative will make sure that the alliance maintains its technological advantage and keeps us safe from threats in a fast and ever-changing world. We've discussed many things with the Secretary General this week, but the bottom line is this. Our government will continue to make sure CAF members have what they need to do their jobs and to protect the freedom of Canadians and our allies and partners. Together with our allies, we are more united than ever. Here at Four Wing Cold Lake, the motto is Auf Wacht, which translates to on watch, little relic from the time spent in Germany. That's what our detection and deterrence missions with NATO and our steadfast commitment to NORAD are all about. Standing on watch and on guard to protect peace and democracy. Merci tout le monde d'être ici, et merci encore une fois, Jens, d'être ici avec nous. It is always such a pleasure to spend time with you. It is always such a pleasure to work alongside you. It is always so important that we continue to stay united and strong in the face of a changing geopolitical environment, and Canada continues to be there at the heart of NATO.